हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज श्वेता रॉय। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर चैप्टर 6 पार्ट 2 वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फैक्टर्स which determine the climate of a place. So here we will discuss about the factors which determine the climate of a place. So the first factor which we will study is latitude or distance from the equator. Second, altitude, distance from the sea, direction of the wind, rainfall. These are some of the factors which determine the climate of a place. So one by one we will discuss about them in detail. Now the first topic is latitude or distance from the equator. Now the places which are near to equator receive more sunlight, as we have already discussed this in our previous video. The places which are close to equator, they receive the direct rays of the sun, they receive more sunlight, and thus they are the hottest region of the earth. Now the places which are far from the equator, they receive less sunlight and they are cold. So here you can see, if there is a distance from the equator, the place is far from the equator, they receive less sunlight and thus they are cold. And the place which is near to equator receive more sunlight, receive direct rays of sun, are hot. So the distance from the equator plays an important role in the climate of the place. So here in the picture also you can have a look and understand. The earth is curved and here the equator is getting the direct sunlight, which is on 90 degrees, and thus this place is the hottest place. But when there is distance from the equator, the places are cooled. Next is altitude. Now the places located on the hills or mountains, they are cooler than the places which are in the plains. The places which are on the raised areas, higher areas, they are cold when we compare it to the plains. So you can understand, the higher elevation are the colder, are having the colder climate. That means when you go on height, when you go on mountains, you will find the climate is cold. This is because the higher altitudes have the less denser air. The air density is less when you go on the heights. So when air density is less, it is not going to trap the sunlight for more time, for a long time. It is not going to trap the sun. It is not capable of trapping the sun for the long time. So this is why the higher elevations are colder. They are having the colder climate. Here in the picture you can see, if you go on sea level, you can find the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. When you are going on 1000 meter height, you will find 23 and 5 degrees Celsius. You are going on 2000 meters, you can find 17 degrees Celsius. When you are going on 300 meters, you will find 105 degrees Celsius. So this is only an example, but in the same way you can find the variation in the temperatures, but it will be the temperature on the raised area, elevated areas will be colder than the areas which is on the sea level. Now the next factor which determine the climate of a place is distance from the sea. Now the area which is close to sea, there is no much variation in the temperature. Because the land breeze and the sea breeze continuously blow from cooler sea to the hotter land and vice versa. This we can understand with this picture. So here you can see the picture. The warm air from the land area is going towards sea and the cool sea breeze is coming towards land. Now in the second picture you can see the cool land breeze is going towards sea and the warm air from the sea is coming towards land. So you can see a circle like this, which is continuously going on. Continuously the cooler, the land breeze and sea breeze are continuously blowing from sea and land. And this keeps the temperature of the earth, the temperature of that place in a average condition. That means there is no much variation. You can find the average temperature near the sea, near the water bodies. Next we have direction of the wind. Now the air moves from high pressure regions to low pressure regions. And this movement of air is called wind. Now this direction of the wind influences the climate of an area. The cold air is denser, and this we can understand by this picture. So you can see the warm air is lighter and thus it is raised up, and in that area you can see there is low pressure. Again you can see when this warm air will become cool, this will be denser and it will create a high pressure. Now as we know, the air moves from high pressure region to low pressure region. So air will move from high pressure region to the low pressure region, and this movement is called wind, and it is also an important factor which determine the climate of a place. Next we have rainfall. Now areas which have heavy rainfall have moderate temperature. The areas with heavy rainfall have moderate temperature, and the areas with less rainfall will have dry and hot climate. Now the deserts are dry and hot regions. They experience dry heat because the annual rainfall is less than 25 cm. So you can see the areas which have heavy rainfall, they have moderate temperature, but the areas which have less rainfall will have dry and hot climate. So you can see the heavy rainfall areas will have the moderate temperature, but the areas which have less rainfall will be dry and hot, like deserts. Now this is time to think. So why do you think Ooty in the Nilgiri Hills remains pleasant throughout the year even though it is close to the equator? So in the map you can see Ooty, and this area is near to the equator, but still the climate in the Ooty remains pleasant. So what is the reason behind that? So actually Ooty is located in the Blue Mountains, which is Nilgiri Hills of Western Ghats. We read about the altitude, and we read that if there is high altitude, the air pressure is low and that area will remain cold. So this area is a high altitude area, and it is a perfect destination for spending holidays during summers, because that time also it has a cool climate. Now the main reason behind it being cool is its position on the Western Ghat. The area on the surface of Earth at the ground level means it is measured according to the level of the sea water. The level of a place is measured as per the level of sea water. So the surface of Earth at the ground level gets heated up due to the sun's radiation. When this hot air climbs the slopes of the Western Ghat. It gets cooled down due to losing its energy, and thus wind becomes cooler. Now, Ooty is situated on higher altitudes. So, by the time this air reaches there, it has become very much cool and pleasant. And this is the main scientific reason behind the low temperature in the hill stations like Ooty. So, altitude, high altitude is the main reason behind the low temperature in hill areas. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.